Hey guys, it's Aman
and Christina
from Our Rich Journey. Welcome back to our stock portfolio update. We are so excited to have you guys back and to be taking you back into our investment portfolio to share with you the results of our investments. If you remember, we started this series in March of 2020 when the stock market was crashing, and we started investing with $5,000. After investing that $5,000, we continued to add to this portfolio. And today, the portfolio is worth over $31,000. And our returns have just been spectacular. So in this video, we are not only gonna go into the portfolio to share the performance, but we are gonna do what we always do. We are gonna answer your questions about investing.
That's right. So like Aman said, in addition to opening up our portfolio, when we do this series of videos, we also answer a question. So in today's video, we are going to be talking to people that are afraid to invest. They have some anxiety about investing in the stock market. So we are going to answer the question of how you get over that anxiety and fear of investing in the stock market, because we have tips for you on how to do that. But first, if you are new to our channel is all about making, saving, and investing money on the road to financial independence. Aman and I pursued financial independence for 8 years. We reached financial independence and we were able to quit our jobs and retire by the age of 40. So if you are interested in learning ways to make, save, or invest money, make sure you subscribe to our channel and follow us on Instagram.
So before we get into our investment portfolio, let's talk about the fear of investing that is keeping you from investing. We are talking to the people out there that are just too scared to get started. And I think we are a prime example of that with this particular portfolio, because we bought into it at a time when fear was probably at its peak in the stock market. And this brings us to the tip that we've always lived by. Do your own research. This is our first tip for anyone that is afraid to start investing in the stock market.
So when we say do your own research, we're really talking about educating yourself about the stock market in general. Understand the history of the stock market, because a lot of people, their fear comes from an anxiety or the fear of the unknown. So the more that you can educate yourself about investing in general in the stock market, the history of the stock market, the more you can understand how the stock market works, the less fear you'll have as you begin investing.
And this less fear translates to confidence. And that's exactly what Christina and I have always had whenever we made an investment. We did our research so that we could move forward and make an investment with confidence. And you'll find that the more you equip yourself with knowledge, you can move forward with sound footing, and this reduces the amount of fear that you have when you invest in the stock market.
The next tip is to have a plan for investing. That will really help to eliminate the fears that you have prior to beginning investing. And a plan can be so very simple. It only needs to have a couple of things. You can put it on a 3x5 note card if you need to, but some of the things that you want to include when you develop a plan: you want to identify your accounts, the investments that you're going to put into your accounts, how you're going to allocate those investments. You also want to know how much and how often you're going to be putting money into those accounts, when you'll be rebalancing, and very importantly, your strategy for accessing that money when you need it.
And I love that particular point, because whenever you make an investment, you should know the end goal for that investment. How will you access that money? Christina and I pursued financial independence with the idea of retiring early based off of our investment accounts. So when we made our investments, it was with that goal in mind.
So like we said, a plan is crucial, so you should really take some time to develop a plan. If you need help in developing one specifically for financial independence and retiring early, we have a stock investing course. And in that course, you'll also be able to develop your own unique investment plan for financial independence and retiring early. Our next tip to help you reduce fear is to start off small. Start investing with small amounts of money. If you have a large amount of money and it's been sitting on the sideline, but at the same time you are fearful about investing it all, just start off by dollar cost averaging. Break that big chunk of money up into smaller amounts and slowly every single month start adding more and more into your account, but break them up into small incremental deposits or investments. Now, if you've watched our channel before, we actually have a video on lump sum investing versus dollar cost averaging, where you have smaller amounts of money and you're putting it in on a very frequent basis. Now, studies actually show if you have a large lump sum of money and you throw that all into the market at once, on average, people that do that perform better than people that take their large amount of money and break it up and put it in incrementally into the market over a longer period of time. And this is because the quicker that you can put your money into the market, the better off you are. So why are we telling you to start small and break it up? It's because these same studies will say that if you are fearful about investing in the market, you would likely do better by breaking it up. Because if you break up your money and start off small, then that fear or anxiety is reduced and it will help you stay calm in periods of volatility with the stock market.
And this is crucial because successful investors must have the proper mindset. And so if you are new to investing and you haven't developed that investor mindset, you're better off slowly getting into the market until you gain that confidence. Now, most of you that are watching this video may not have a large lump sum of money sitting around that you have to put into the market. You'll be in a situation where you're going to be dollar cost averaging into the market anyway. So if you are in that situation, still start out small, but work your way up to a level that will help you achieve your overall goal for your investments.
Our next tip to you: once you actually begin investing, you can still have some fear or anxiety as your money is sitting in its investment. Our tip to you is do not look at your portfolio. Stay away from it. If you are constantly checking your portfolio every single day, every week, even every single month, there is a lot of volatility in the stock market, and that creates a lot of anxiety and fear if you're following the market that closely.
So if you have an app and you are constantly checking the balance on your investment accounts, we don't recommend that. If you are constantly watching investment news, which is really headline scary news, we don't recommend that either. What we recommend is that you set yourself up a schedule for when you will routinely check your accounts. And if something changes in your life that requires you to change that schedule, then check your accounts. But don't check your accounts every single day. Every time you see a headline, that is a recipe for a disaster.
Our next tip is to prepare your mindset to be a successful investor. And that means understanding that you are not going to get rich overnight. And it also means understanding that the stock market is very volatile. Now let's talk about not getting rich overnight. Because when you begin investing, if you feel like you should be getting rich a lot quicker than you are, you can start having that anxiety and fear creep up because you feel like you're not being successful. But if you go in with a proper mindset and understand that it takes time to grow your wealth in the stock market, that will help reduce some of that fear and anxiety you have with investing.
And this brings us to our last tip, and the tip that helps us sleep so good at night with our investments. And it is understanding that the historical return of the stock market has always been positive. Now, what I mean by this is that if you look at any chart of the stock market, it is down here and it ends up there. You'll have bumps in the road, but consistently the stock market has historically always gone up. And so with that knowledge, we feel so confident investing our money in the stock market. We don't invest with fear of losing all of our money because history has shown us that time and time again, the stock market has always gone up. Now, with these tips in mind, we hope that you can also invest with confidence. Go out, do your research, develop your plan, have an exit strategy for how you're gonna get your money when you retire early, but get started investing. But without further ado, let's get into the performance of our stock portfolio. We are excited to jump in and share with you the performance of our portfolio.
But first, if you recall, we invested $5,000 into this account initially. And then each month after that, we invested another $1,200 between our three index funds in this account. So let's start off with our first investment, FZROX, which is Fidelity's Zero Total Stock Market Index Fund. In June 15th, we invested $720 into FZROX. We bought 46.936 shares at $15.34 each. We now own a total of 1,221.68 shares at an average price of $11.42 per share. Our total amount invested is $13,957.32. Our current value is $19,192.40. That's up $5,235.08, or 37.50%. Our next investment is FZILX, which is Fidelity's Zero International Index Fund. On June 15th, we invested $240 into FZILX. We bought 18.927 shares at $12.68 each. We now own a total of 476.363 shares at an average price of $9.79 per share. Our total amount invested is $4,661.82. Our current value is $5,935.48. That's up $1,273.66, or 27.32%. And our last investment in this portfolio is FSRNX, that is Fidelity's Real Estate Index Fund. On June 15th, we invested $240 into FSRNX. We bought 13.341 shares at $17.99 each. We now own a total of 345.752 shares at an average price of $13.59 per share. Our total amount invested is $4,698.42. Our current value is $6,157.84. That's up $1,459.42, or 31.06%. Overall, the current value of our portfolio is $31,285.72. That's up $7,968.16, or 34.17%.
So that's it. That's our stock portfolio update. And it is just amazing to see this portfolio grow. We have no doubt that one day we'll be sharing this portfolio with you and it will be over $100,000. Mm-hmm. And we will just keep going and answering your questions about investing in the stock market. Because what we want to do with this series is show you how everyday people can build wealth by consistently investing in the stock market. And so if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and
join the journey.